Hello guys, welcome to my today class. Now in this class I'm going to discuss few more problems based on total derivative, implicit and composite functions. We already discussed exclusively and spent 25 minutes to explain implicit, composite and total derivative definitions. Okay, if u equals x into log of xy and x cube plus y cube minus 3axy, a is some constant, equal to 1, find du by dx. This problem is very, very important. They are given so many times in the question paper. Now, observe carefully, I told number of times, expression involving in the left hand side, what actually, x and y equal to 1, then find du by dx. Now, observe carefully, u is function of x and y. What is the given here? Given is, now try to understand that this is a one, this is a combination of two definitions. Okay, given what is u? X into log of xy, and also they given one equation left hand side involving in terms of x and y, right hand side is a constant because one is a constant. Observe carefully, u is function of x and y. What they given? U is a function of what? X and y. Okay, fine. But I want to find out du by dx. Understood, y is a function of x. And also, x is function itself. See, you know that from the definition of ordinary derivative, if you want to find out ordinary derivative means how many independent variables are expecting? Only one. What is that independent variable? Is nothing but x. Observe carefully, u is function of x and y, but I want to find out du by dx. Means both x and y are functions of x. Therefore, how many independent variables have? One. From the definition of total derivative, observe carefully, u is function of x and y, where x and y are functions of one of the independent variables x. From the definition of total derivative, what is du by dx? Du by dx. Now, how can you take, ma'am, without giving y is function of x? Because u is function of x and y, but I want to find out u with respect to x means understood y is also a function of x. From the definition of total derivative, du by dx, because u is dependent on two variables x and y, into dx by dx plus du by dou y into dy by dx. Yeah, dx dx is cancelled. What is this value? Must be 1. Now you have u. What is u? You have x into log of xy. It's a function of two log of x into y. It's a function of two variables. Therefore, now I go for partial derivative. What is derivative of u with respect, partial derivative of u with respect to x? You go for product rule because it's a function of both x and y. From the product rule, what is derivative of x with respect to x? 1 into second function plus first function into, I have to find out derivative of log because involving x also, x into y. With respect to x, which is constant y, into derivative of x with respect to x is 1. Now, you simplify that, what we get actually, log of xy, x and y are cancelled, xx cancel and yy cancel. Now, what we get actually here? Plus 1. Okay, fine. Now, I have to find out what is partial derivative of u with respect to y. With respect to y, which is constant? X is constant. Therefore, derivative of log is 1 by xy. Into derivative of xy with respect to y is what? X into 1. Now, xx cancel. Now, what's the remaining? X by y. But, I want to find out dy by dx. How to find out dy by dx? You have a equation. What's the equation have? You have an equation, what actually, x cube plus y cube minus 3axy equal to 1. We discussed already implicit function. The left-hand side is involving the function of x and y. Right-hand side must be a constant or 0. U f of x y, but right hand side must be a constant of 0. How to find out dy by dx? What's the formula? Minus fx divided by fy. Where what is my f is nothing but left hand side expression is in purely involving x and y. Keep in mind right hand side must be constant or 0. Then only we possible to go for this formula. Suppose any term is involving x and y, better it to shifted in the left hand side. Okay. Now, but already in the standard form, left hand side is involving in terms of x and y, right hand side is nothing but a constant. Is one is a constant, therefore, what is dy by dx formula is minus fx divided by fy. Okay. The question is arise. Suffix y. Don't confuse here. Suffix x and suffix y. This is nothing but another way of notation of partial derivative of f with respect to x, with respect to y, where what is my f of x y? What is my f of x y? Left hand side expression of the equation x cube plus y cube minus 3axy. What is dou f by dou x is nothing but with respect to x, which is constant, y is constant. Only temporarily y is constant, the rest of the thing is just like an ordinary. What is derivative of x cube is 3x square. This is 0 because derivative of constant is 0. Minus 3a, y is constant. What is derivative of x with respect to x is 1. Now, if you want to take common factor from these two, what's the common factor? 3 into x square minus ay. Okay, fine. Similarly, I have to find out dou f by dou y. With respect to y, which is constant, x is constant, this is 0. Derivative of y cube with respect to y is 3y square. 3y square minus 3ax is constant into derivative of y with respect to y is 1. What's a common factor? 3y square minus ax. Okay, fine. Now we are going to substitute these values where instead of fx and fy. What is dy by dx is nothing but minus of 3 times of x square minus ay divided by 3 times of y square minus ax. Now 3 cancel. Suppose you take minus and insert the bracket in the numerator, ay minus x square divided by y square minus ax. This is nothing but my dy by dx. Therefore, du by dx is nothing but from the total derivative definition, dou u by dou x. What is my dou u by dou x? Just few minutes before we find out, 1 plus log of 1 xy. Yeah, 1 plus log of xy or x log of xy plus 1, both are must be same. Plus dou u by dou y is nothing but x by y into dy by dx. What is dy by dx? Ay minus x square divided by y square minus ax. Now here, keep in mind, use any method. If you want to find out du by dx, means I'm required a solution in terms of x or constant. But here we have x or constant involving what actually y. Because you have a y is function of x, you want to find out dy by dx, we are expecting a solution in terms of x or constant. Like that, use any method to find out the derivative of u with respect to x. Here, now, we are expecting a solution in terms of x or constant. But you have other than, x is y. But you already taken y is also a function of x, where y is a function of x. Because we already assumed that. Therefore, don't worry about, even though involved y. Suppose involving y also, don't worry because you already taken y is function of x. This is a way I have to find out derivative of u with respect to x. Before moving to the next problem, I'm going to zoom out for this. Observe carefully, this problem is a combination of definition of total derivative and implicit function definition. This is one of the important problem. What they given in the problem? In the problem, they given if u is x into log of xy, and also they given expression in terms of x and y. Right hand side is 1. Find du by dx. If you want to find out du by dx, u is function of x and y. That understood, both x and y are functions of x. Then only you are expecting how many independent variable? Only one independent variable. Then is possible I go for total derivative. Therefore, even though they are not mentioned, observe carefully, they are expecting ordinary differentiation, means you are expecting one independent variable. Therefore, that understood you, x and y are depends upon one of the independent variable, single independent variable is x. From the total derivative, write the formula. After that, you find out dou u by dou x and dou u by dou y. Already given u is function of x and y. Then you find out carefully with respect to x, treat it temporarily, y is constant. With respect to y, treat it temporarily, which one is constant, x is constant. And next, I want to find out dy by dx. We already discussed in implicit function definition. Left hand side is involving in terms of x and y. Right hand side is a constant or zero. In such cases, what's the formula we derived in the previous class? Dy by dx is equal to minus fx by fi. Keep in mind, suppose the given expression like that x cube plus y cube must be equal to 3axy plus 1. This is not f of xy. First, keep the right hand side only is involving either constant or maybe a zero. That form I had to convert. Then only after that only I had to choose f of xy. This is not f of xy. Once you convert the right hand side having a constant or zero, what are the terms you have in the left hand side in terms of x and y is nothing but f of xy. Find out the partial derivative of f with respect to x, with respect to y, substitute. And then finally substitute the values of du u by du x, du u by du y, dy by dx. Even though du by dx, you are expecting a solution in terms of x are constant, but is involving what actually? Y. Don't worry about that because you already assumed that in beginning of the problem, y is a function of x. Therefore, this is the way I have to find out the solution. It's a combination of total derivative and implicit function definitions. Therefore, this is one of the important problem. Okay. Yeah. Now, I move to the next problem. Okay. Fine. Yeah. Next problem. Second problem. Today's second problem. If u equals f of y minus z, comma z minus x, comma x minus y, prove that dou u by dou x plus dou u by dou y plus dou u by dou z must be equal to 0. Okay, fine. Now observe carefully here, u is function of x, y, z. Observe carefully, u is a function of x, y, z. But I want to find out partial derivative of u with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to z. But this given function is not in any one of the form. It's not in directly, it's not in the form of total derivative, implicit or composite function. Therefore, because they given some unknown function here. For our reference, now I'm going to take let new variable say r, st, where r is equal to y minus z. S is nothing but z minus x. And then t is nothing but x minus y. I'm trying to express the given function into any one of the standard form, either composite function, implicit function, or maybe total derivative form. Therefore, once you choose r, s, t, what we get actually, u must be function of r, s, t, where r, s, and t are totally are functions of x, y, z, are functions of x, y, and z. I think it's clear how to proceed for this. u is function of rst, where rst are functions of x, y, z. Now observe, u is dependent on how many variables? 3. R, S, T. Okay, fine. These R, S, T are functions of X, Y, Z. Therefore, what are the independent variables here? The independent variables are X, Y, Z. U is dependent on more than one independent variable. Therefore, you can't go for total derivative. You can't go for implicit function definition. Only the possibility I go for which definition? Composite function. Because u is function of more than one variable. All the variables are depending upon more than one independent variables. How many? 3 independent variables. Therefore, now we go for which definition? Composite function definition. Yes. Therefore, from the definition of composite function, yeah, I think it's clear why I should take composite function, because u is function of RST, depends upon more. Again, RST is depending upon more than one independent variable, independent variables. Therefore, I go for what composite function definition. Partial derivative of u, what are the independent variables here? X, Y, Z, u with respect to X. But u is function of RST from the chain rule, dou u by dou r into dou r by dou X, and also u also function of S, dou u by dou S into dou S by dou X. It's also function of T, dou u by dou T into dou T by dou X. Everywhere I am writing partial, because again RST is depending upon more than one independent variable. In none of the place you can't write ordinary. U also depending upon more than one, RST also depending upon more than one. And also I have to find out independent variables are nothing but with respect to X, with respect to Y, and with respect to Z. Again, u is function of RST from the chain rule dou u by dou r into dou r by dou y plus dou u by dou s into dou s by dou y plus dou u by dou t into dou t by dou y. Is also depends upon independent variable z, dou u by dou z. It's nothing but u is function of RST, dou u by dou r into dou r by dou z plus dou u by dou s into dou s by dou z plus dou u by dou t into dou t by dou z. Yeah. Now I have to substitute these values here. Yeah. But they given u is function of x, y, z, right? Okay, fine. This is a simple one. I'm going to substitute directly for dou u by dou x for the right hand side value. Observe carefully. They given u is function of RST. Therefore, what is dou u by dou r? Dou u by dou r only. Can't write any known value here because f is unknown. F is a function of RST they given. You can't write any definite value here. Therefore, I leave it dou u by dou r as itself, because you can't write it any value, definite value in terms of r. Just they mention u is function of RST. But what is r? R is y minus z. What is dou r by dou z? With respect to z, only z vary. The remaining variables are constant. Therefore, y is 0. What is derivative of z with respect to z is 1. We get minus 1. This is simple. Therefore, I'm going to write it directly. And then plus dou u by dou s into, again, I'm written dou u by dou s as itself, because just they given u is function of RST. What is s? Actually z minus x. With respect to z minus x, with respect to z only vary 1 minus 0. What we get? 1. And then dou u by dou t into, t is not with respect to, I did mistake here, just a minute, yeah, Just a minute. Yeah. Not for with respect to Z. First you find out do u by do x. Just a minute. Yeah, sorry. Because I observe for this, that's why I taken do u, do r by do z. 1 minute. Yeah. See, observe the last derivative, no? If I'm explaining that. Sorry. Do u by do x. But anyway, u is function of rst. Therefore, we can't write any function, any value in terms of r. Leave it do u by do r. Do r by do x. What is do r by do x? With respect to x. With respect to x, what are the constant? Y and z are constant. What is derivative of constant? Is 0. Sorry. With respect to x, first I have to find out. Do u by do x, I'll leave it as itself. Do s by do x, because we are finding do u by do x. What is do s by do x? With respect to x, that is constant 0 minus 1. Derivative of x with respect to x. Do u by do t into, with respect to do t by do x, with respect to x, 1 minus 0, because y is constant. Therefore, we get 1. Okay, fine. Now, once you simplify that, what we get actually, do u by do x is nothing but minus do u by do s plus do u by do t. Okay, fine. And then similarly, I have to find out what actually do u by do y. What is do u by do y? Do u by do y, again u is function of rst, you can't treat any value. Leave it do u by do r. What is do r by do y? Now you already know that what is r? R is a function of y and z. With respect to y, 1 minus 0. What we get actually? 1. Okay. Plus do u by do s into partial derivative of z with respect to y. It's not a function of y. Z and x is constant. What is derivative of constant is 0. Plus do u by do t, derivative of partial derivative of t with respect to y. 0 minus 1. Suppose you simplify that, what we get, do u by do y is nothing but do u by do r minus do u by do t. And next we are going to find out similarly what actually do u by do z. Do u by do z is nothing but do u by do r, you can't write any value, you already know that, into r with respect to z. With respect to z means z only varies, 0 minus 1. Plus do u by do s into, with respect to z, z is vary, x is constant, therefore we get 1. Derivative of that with respect to z. Do u by do t into, it's not a function of z, therefore what is derivative, partial derivative of t with respect to z is 0. This implies do u by do z is nothing but minus do u by do r plus do u by do s. Now I have to take, prove that, no, now I have to take LHS. And then I have to show that RHS. What is RHS? RHS is 0. Okay, fine. Now I have to take LHS. LHS equals, yeah. What is my LHS? Do u by do x plus do u by do y plus do u by do z. Substitute do u by do x value minus do u by do s plus do u by do t. What is do u by do y value? Plus do u by do r minus do u by do t. What is do u by do z values? Minus do u by do r plus do u by do s. Observe carefully, all the terms are cancelled. Minus, plus, do u by do t, minus, plus, these are cancelled. What we get actually is 0. That is nothing but RHS. Yeah, this is also one of the important problem. Basically, the given function is not in any one of the standard form of the definition. Suppose it's not in the standard form of the form, how to convert in the standard form? That's a very, very important. Now, it's given u is a function of y minus z, z minus x, x minus y. I want to find out partial derivative of u with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to z. This is, here we are expecting what actually partial derivative. This shows that u is dependent on more than one independent variables r, x, y, z. Therefore, what I did here, I taken this first coordinate is r, Second coordinate is, yes, this is t. Now we get u is function of r as t, where r, s and t are function of three independent variables r, x, y, z. Now we, from the definition of composite function only we are going to write. We can't apply total derivative. Keep in mind, if you want to go for total derivative, you are expecting only one single independent variable. That must be dependent on all other variable, not for the different single independent variable. Okay, then you write dou u by dou x, dou u by dou y, dou u by dou z using chain rule and carefully substitute the values of, you can't substitute dou u by dou r, dou u by dou s and dou u by dou t, because just we given u is function of r s t. We leave it as itself and then we have to write the value of r, s, t with respect to x, y, z. Then we take LHS of the given problem. Substitute and simplify that, automatically we get right hand side. I think it's clear. Now I'll move to the next problem. Okay. Problem. See, the rest of the problem you refer any textbook. Once you clear the concept, then easy to solve the remaining problem. Okay, fine. If third problem, if z equals log of u square plus v, where u is nothing but e power of x square plus y square and v is nothing but x square plus y. Find, yeah, observe carefully, z is function of u and v, where u and v are functions of x and y. What are the independent variables? X and y. Therefore, can't find out ordinary, I have to find out partial dou u by, not u, dou z by dou x and dou z by dou y. Because z is function of x and u and v, where u and v are functions of what actually? Functions of x and y. What are the independent variables here? Independent variables are x and y. Can't find out ordinary. I have to find out partial. Dou z by dou y. Now observe the what about the function itself, easy to know that. What are the values they given? Given z equals log of u square plus v. Okay, fine. And where u is nothing but e power of x square plus y square. E power of x square plus y square can also be written as e power of x square into y square. These are same, add up their indices, we get same thing. E power of what actually? X square plus y square. This is e power, the power of that. Okay. And then what's the v value? X square plus y square. Fine. That is function of u and v. U and v are function of x and y. Therefore, I have to find out dou z by dou x and dou z by dou y using what? Which definition? Composite function definition. From the composite function definition, but z is not basically function of x and y, is a function of u and v. From the chain rule, dou z by dou u into dou u by dou x. And also, z is a function of v, dou z by dou v into dou v by dou x. Okay, first you find out dou z by dou y. Now, what is my z they given? Given z is nothing but log of u square plus v. Yeah. Z is not a constant with respect to u and v. With respect to u, what is derivative of log? 1 by u square plus v. Yeah. What is into derivative of this with respect to u is 2u plus derivative of constant is 0. Okay. And next I want to find out dou z by dou v. Again, partial derivative of log is 1 by u square plus v into derivative of v with respect to v is 1, this is 0, we get 1, okay. The next is, I want to find out which value here, Yeah, I'll do it here only. Yeah, what is my u is e power of x square into y square. Okay, fine. X square into e power of y square. What is my v? X square plus y square. Okay, fine. I want to find out dou u by dou x. With respect to x, which one is constant? E power of y square is constant. What is derivative of e power of x square? E power of x square into derivative of x square with respect to x is 2x. What is dou v by dou x? With respect to x, y is constant, we get 2x. Okay? If we want to find out with respect to y also, because further I want this value, because while finding dou z by dou y, instead of x, what we get actually dou u by dou y and dou v by dou y. Therefore, what is dou u by dou y? With respect to y, e power of x square is constant. What is derivative of e power of y square? E power of y square into 2y. Fine. Similarly, with respect to v, with respect to y, y x is constant, we get 2y. Okay. Now, I have to find out dou z by dou x. What is my dou z by dou x? It's nothing but dou z by dou u is nothing but 2u divided by u square plus v into dou u by dou x. What is dou u by dou x? Is nothing but e power of x square plus, if you want to combine it together, plus y square. Basis of same add up their indices, we get x square plus y square into 2x. Plus dou z by dou v is 1 by u square plus v into dou v by dou x is nothing but 2x. I think it's clear this one. In the next step, before move to the next step, dou z by dou x is nothing but what's a common factor? From these two terms, the common factor is 2x divided by u square plus v is a common factor. What's the remaining now? The remaining is nothing but 2u. Try to understand that 2 into 2u into e power of x square plus y square. What is e power of x square plus y square? It's nothing but u. We get u into u is u square. Keep in mind, we have taken 2x by u square plus v is a common factor. 2u into e power of x square plus y square is nothing but u, we get u square plus 1. Okay. Now observe carefully. Now see, observe here dou z by dou x is nothing but what? Actually 2x divided by this. Now partial derivative of z with respect to x. Now this is nothing but this is a way I have to find out partial derivative of z with respect to x. Next I move to the what actually? Dou z by dou y. Next, if you want, now I have to move what actually with respect to y. Yeah, with respect to y. Dou z by dou y. What is dou z by dou y? It's nothing but, yeah, dou z by dou y is nothing but z is function of u and v, dou z by dou u into dou u by dou y plus, it's also function of v, dou z by dou v into dou v by dou y. Okay. What is my dou z by dou u? What is my dou z by dou u? Is nothing but 2u divided by u square plus v. What is into dou u by dou y is nothing but e power of x square y plus y square into 2y. Okay, fine. Plus dou z by dou v is nothing but 1 by u square plus v into dou v by dou y is 2y. Now as usual, you take common factor for this. What's a common factor? Yeah. Now I'm going to take the common factor is dou z by, this is a common factor, you know that 2y and here partial derivative of V did then yeah, just a minute. Yeah, here I written x square plus y square, correct. Yeah, problem is correct, I written. Okay, fine. Yeah, 2y, what's a common factor from these two? 2y divided by, okay, fine, u square plus v is a common factor. Yeah, 2u, again e power of x square plus y square is u, we get 2u square plus 1. Okay, now this is a way I have to find out dou z by dou y and dou z by dou x. But you already know that if you want to write here where u and v are functions of x and y, is already given clearly. Here also if you want to write where, because you have a doubt, they are asking dou z by dou y, then involve where u and v are functions of x and y, because it's a partial derivative, no, it's not a ordinary derivative. Suppose ordinary derivative are expecting only one independent variable. Dou z by dou y means only y vary, the remaining variables are constant. That's all. This way I have to find out partial derivative of the given function with respect to x, with respect to y, using which definition? Composite function definition. Now I solved totally three problems for this class. One problem is combination of total derivative and what about that implicit function definition. Two problems based on composite functions. You please refer any textbook and engineering, higher engineering mathematics for mathematics by Grewal textbook, refer. And also in block syllabus, they mentioned very clearly what are the section we are going to refer in Grewal textbook. Higher engineering mathematics by Grewal textbook, if there they mentioned, you please go through that, you solve more number of problems. Before I'm going to wind up the class, one thing you have to remember, suppose you clear the concept, then easy to solve any type of problem. We can't expecting only maybe use such this type of problem in the class. We can't stick on only 10 or 15 problems. How we were prepared, suppose you know the concept on the spot, suppose they give any type of function, you have to solve comfortably. Okay. Thank you very much for listening today, this class. Yeah, in this class, I completed implicit, composite and total derivative definitions problems. Okay. In the next class, I'm coming back with Jacobian. Based on the Jacobian, I'm going to discuss few problems. Thank you very much. Bye. See you and take care.